Hey guys, Mary from SVG Cuts here with some brand new box cards for Christmas and beyond. I'm really happy with the way that they all came out. I think my favorite might be this Nativity Scene box card. I spent a whole entire day fine-tuning it and getting all the little parts just how I wanted them to be. Nice and detailed, but not too detailed for its size. So that'll be a really fun one to make and send. The cool thing about it is that you can cut the whole card out of one piece of 12 by 12 paper, and it's really pretty straightforward to put together. You can have fun adding some dimension with some little foam squares or 3D dots like I did if you want. And I used a cute little twinkle star on the front from Queen & Company. So we have four more box cards too. I think this little star is super cute, quick and easy, dimensional. The cool thing about all the box cards is that they fold flat to go inside their envelope, but when they come out, they look really dimensional and really cool. So this star box card could totally work for New Year's Eve or a birthday card or patriotic summertime 4th of July card or what have you. So hopefully that comes in handy all year long for you too. And we've also got this really pretty amaryllis card. Also nice and simple, quick and easy to put together. But again, all that dimension just looks really cool. So another good example of some nice dimension is the new Rooftops box card. It's got two inserts inside of it, so there's lots of dimension with all those little snowy houses. And I think you could make it without the Santa as a wintertime card for someone's birthday or, you know, a thank you card or thinking of you or whatever. You could even stamp on the moon if you wanted to, or like I did, stamp on the backside. Finally, we've got our cute little gingerbread house box card, which is really fun to embellish with some fun little doodads. I have a big stash of these really cool rivets by Queen & Company, which is what I used on the front of mine because I think they look like little candies. But of course, whatever you have in your stash that you want to use, I think is going to look really cool. I also had fun with this with some liquid pearls that I have. It's kind of like puffy paint. And I added some little dots around on that as well. I've got all my pieces cut out to show you how each box card goes together, so let's get started. So first I'm going to put together our amaryllis box card, and we've got this little trim piece here, which I cut out of gold mirror paper, and then the backside panel there, this front panel that goes on the front flap, as well as the flower parts and the stems, this insert that goes in the front, as well as this insert that goes inside, and then the body of the box card itself, which we can fold up just like this and fold that flap backwards. If you want, you can crease it a little harder. And then we can glue our front flap right onto it. Then I'm going to go ahead and glue the back panel in place. And then I'm going to put a few dots of glue on this frame part. And center that right on the inside of the back. So if you take a look at your PDF document, this is the first page, which is the amaryllis box card. You can see that the inside of the back is kind of laid out like that. I went ahead and glued that part back there, and then we're gonna put this part on next and the blossoms. And then the insert here and the front insert. So if you want, you could take a darker green ink pad and rub it on the edges of some of these stems a little bit. I'm just going to go ahead and put it together as is, which is fine too. And then I'm going to bend these leaves in half gently on both of these. Then these are just going to get layered on top of each other like this. So I do want to take a darker red ink pad. I happen to have this handy. It's from a Q. This one's called Pink Sky. I don't know if that'll really show up as much as I want it to. And then maybe this one would be a little better. That's called Red Barn. So this is a stack of Cat's Eye ink pads from Colorbox, which I got on Amazon. And I just want to darken in the center of my flower like that. It doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to do this step either. Totally optional. But I think it makes it look a little more dimensional and a little more realistic and interesting. So I'm gonna do that for mine. Then, if you want to just gently bend your petals a little bit, you can. And then I'll just put some glue on the back side and glue it one on top of the other and flatten it out a little bit so that it sticks. Then I'm going to take my liquid pearls, which I recently kind of organized my craft supplies and realized that I should use some of my fun little doodads more, such as this. So that does take a little bit of time to dry. I'll just be really careful when I'm putting mine together. Next, I am going to glue this inside the front. Like so. And then I'm going to take some glue and put it on the back side of each of these. I'm going to just glue down the two outer ones, and then I'm going to use a dimensional pop dot on the center one. That's totally up to you. That's just what I feel like doing. But I've got these 3D Zots by Thermoweb. I use them quite a bit to add dimension when I want to. So it's just a super sticky little dot. I'll put it on the back there. And then Just position that where I want it. So our card is coming together. It looks really pretty. I'm gonna put some glue on the side tab of this insert here. So as you can see, the tab here is flush with the back and it's nice and perpendicular. So I'll go ahead and glue the other side down. Just like that. And there is our card. I forgot to stamp on the back of mine this time. So there's our card. So if you were gonna stamp on it, I suppose at this point, for me it's a little late now, but I used this stamp on my original card. Next, for the gingerbread house box card, I've got the page from the PDF here in your download. And if you want to take a look, it shows you what the front and sides look like with everything glued on, as well as the insert and then the inside of the back. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp on this circle with my stamp here. And so this piece is the front of our card. We've got four little windows here and a little door. We've got some other icing details. And then this goes on the back side. This is the insert here, which gets folded like this. And then this is the back with the two sides attached. So I'm going to go ahead and glue this piece onto the back. And the circle that I stamped on right into the center there. And all four of these windows are the same exact shape and size, so it doesn't matter which one goes where. And I'll go ahead and glue the two side windows on. Next, I'm going to glue this piece onto my insert. With the door centered on the bottom there. Then this piece, I could just fold, or I could just glue it down flat, but I'm going to use some of my 3D Zots by ThermalWeb to add some dimension, like this. And then glue this piece. Right onto the front there. As well as my little windows. and this piece. On my original card, I used some glitter glue, some stickles, and crystal, and I put some little tiny dots all the way around each window, and a couple of little dots here and there, and I kind of rubbed some on the little leaves there. So if you wanted to do something like that, that's what I did. And then, if you want to add your little cute little embellishments, you can. I might just leave it like that, that's cute too. Then I'm gonna take this big piece here, bend my little chimney top over. And glue this piece down. So I did, on my original card, I put some little dots with my liquid pearls. You might want to do this at the end of your project so that you can let it dry without having to touch it. Next, I will put some glue on the side tab here and glue that right down. So the back of that little tab is flush with the back of the inside there, and we can put the other side in place the same way. Next, we can glue our front on with some glue on the side, on the tab there on the side. And glue both sides together. On my original card, I also added some little opals by Queen & Company around the top there, as well as some red ones on the side. I happen to have quite a bit of these in my stash, but I think pretty much anything you want to use or put on there is going to look really cute. Next, for the Nativity box card, if you take a look at your PDF, you can see how it's kind of glued together here a little bit, how there's a rectangle on the front. There's another rectangle on the front of this insert, and then the way that the inside of the back is layered with the angel and the reinforced area there. So we've got our little angel, which is part of the back, these two decorative flap panels. This piece goes right on the front. which you can just, you can glue right on and it looks really nice and finished off. Or if you want to run this through your embossing machine with some kind of embossing folder, you can do that. That's what I did on my original. I have this card, or this embossing folder. It's Mate Lasse by Anna Griffin for Cuddlebug. Last time I looked, I do not see this anymore. So if you are in love with it and you really want to have it, I'm sorry to tease you with it. But I'm sure there are plenty of other embossing folders that would look really cool. So the little parts for the star, and then this piece, which goes on the back. This rectangle goes on this insert here. And then this is the back side of the card, which we can fold like this and reverse that flap there. I'm gonna use my bone folder to crease it a little more sharply. So I'm gonna go ahead and glue these down. I'm gonna skip the embossing this time and just go for it. Glue everything together. This is a little confusing. Right. Oh, there we go. If you wanted to stamp anything on the back, now is a good time. I'm going to go ahead and use this stamp again. From the Holy Night stamp set from Kaiser Craft, which I got a couple years ago. I'm not seeing it anymore, but I do see some others out there that would also be great. So hopefully you've already got something that would work. So next, I would like to put my angel on. You could just glue it down, or if you want to add some dimension, I have these little 3D foam squares by Scrapbook Adhesives. I think the packaging looks slightly different now, but it's nice and tiny, which is perfect for this little piece here. Next, I'm going to glue this piece right onto it. It just kind of reinforces everything, and if you wanted to run it through an embossing folder with this part sticking out of the folder and this part in the folder, you could emboss it. Next, I'll glue my little star on. I'm going to use another little foam square on the back side of this part. And just kind of offset it right there. And then glue this on with a little dot of glue. Then I've got these little twinkle stars from Queen & Company, which I think will be adorable right on there. Or just a little circular one would look awesome. Next, I'm going to glue this piece onto the front. And glue this piece onto the insert. Then I'll put some glue on this side tab of this piece and glue that right inside so that the back of the tab is flush with the back of the box. And I'll do the same thing on the other side tab. Then I can glue my front on. Just like this. Got a little helper over here. Helping. Such an amazing helper. And some glue here. So that's my card. If you want, you can glue these flaps down or you can leave it, whatever you think looks nice. On my original one, I used some 3D Zots by ThermoWeb to kind of hold the sides down because I kind of like it like that, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna leave this one like this or what, but there is your card. Next, for the rooftops box card, I've got this page of the PDF here. You can see how the inserts are kind of laid out and also the buildings with the little windows, how they get glued on the inside. I think you don't necessarily have to see that to tell how they go together. What we're gonna do is just glue these pieces on the back side of our buildings. And just by process of elimination, you can tell what piece goes where. So I'm just gonna lay them out and glue them down. So I'll just put a few dots of glue around the edge of each window or directly on the back of the building, whatever you want to do. Next, I'm going to put together the front of the card, which is this piece, and this gets glued right onto it. So the corner of the building right here, we're going to have it line up with where the roof kind of ends right there. Next, there's this insert. And I'll glue this onto it. And here's insert two. Then for the back side of my card, I'm going to get out an ink pad that's a little darker than the moon and add some dimension. Make it look a little bit rounder. As well as a dark blue. I already kind of rubbed a dark blue around the edge of this shape. I kind of goofed up and got a little too crazy with it, but that's okay. So I'm going to glue my moon onto my sky, just right in the center so that the bottoms line up. And then I'm going to glue that inside. Just like that. I think I'll stamp on it before it's too late. And then these two shapes are identical, and I'm just gonna glue it on with a few dots of glue, but I'm gonna put the top layer a little higher up than the bottom so that it kind of looks like light is shining up onto the bottom of it. That's the idea. So, I just want it to be almost right on top of each other, but just raised up a little bit. So you could glue that right on if you wanted, or if you want to use some dimensional dots, I'm going to use these 3D foam squares by Scrapbook Adhesives, because they're nice and tiny. I mean, you could really put it however you want. I kind of like it like this, like they're taken off. And then I'm gonna do my glitter glue after everything is together. So next I will put some glue on that side tab and glue it right down, the back of the tab flush with the back of the box. I'll do the same thing on the other side. Then I'll do the same thing with this insert. time. So the back of that tab is flush with the piece behind it. Everything is nice and perpendicular and parallel so that your card folds flat. So before it's completely dry, you can kind of make sure that it's going to fold flat. And then glue the front into place. So there's your card. Now, if you want to do some glitter glue like I did, I just kind of, instead of covering the whole thing with glitter, I just kind of did some side-to-side motions on it like this. And I just kind of put it wherever. I think it looks cool. So finally, for the star box card, I've got two shiny pieces and some glitter pieces. This piece is the front of the card. And you can see this all laid out in your PDF document there. Then this piece is insert one, and this is gonna get glued right onto it. Then we've got insert two. This will get glued right onto it. And if it's not looking like it's lining up, that's because the bottom sides go straight down, whereas the others are slightly different. So you want it to be lined up just like that for all of them. And then the main part of the box card is this. You can bend this backwards and crease it a little harder. I'm gonna go ahead and stamp again with the same stamp, nice and easy. Like this. Then I'll glue my two sides on. So next I'll glue this other side panel down. And glue this star onto this insert. And this star onto the other insert. And I'll glue this trim piece onto the front. So now I'm going to glue this small insert inside the back here. So I'll put some glue on that side tab and glue that right inside, flush with the back, nice and perpendicular and parallel, just just like that. As well as on the other side. And then I'll do the same with this other insert. And then I can glue the front right on. So the front has straight sides on the bottom. If you turn it like this, the sides are not quite straight up and down. So you want to make sure that you've got it so that these two sides are straight here, and then glue that onto the front. And there you have it. So I can't wait to see how this one looks in other colors and other themes. So there you have it, super fun, dimensional, yet pretty straightforward box cards for you to make and send and give. I hope you have a great time making them. And if you do, you'll have to share a picture with us on Facebook, Instagram, your blog, Pinterest, however you like to share. I always love to see, and so do the rest of our crafty friends. So thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time, and happy crafting.